2018 Jaguar E-Pace. The Jaguar E-Pace is the British car maker's second SUV, joining the hugely successful F-Pace. This is the large SUV that, in just 1 year of production, has already been crowned the 2017 World Car of the Year and become Jaguar's best-selling model. The desire for Jaguar to create another smaller, more affordable SUV therefore seems to be as logical as it is exciting. Sadly, E-Pace doesn't mean electric, that's reserved for the forthcoming I-Pace SUV – it just means smaller than F-Pace. Instead, this baby SUV will be available with four-cylinder gasoline and diesel engines as well as the choice of front or all-wheel drive, although only the entry-level 148-horsepower diesel can be ordered with front-wheel drive, outside of the United States. Given that popularity and consumer confidence around it word is dropping, the diesel engine won't even be offered in the US. We've focused here on testing the petrol-powered E-Pace P300R Dynamic HSE with 296 horsepower, all-wheel drive, and a 9-speed automatic transmission. Jaguar describes it as being as close to building a hot hatch as the company will ever get. Those striking proportions do take priority over passenger space, with access into the rear seats impeded by both the sloping roofline and large wheel arch cutaways that accommodate a maximum, and huge, 20-inch alloy. Storage space up front is good, with a center console that houses multiple USB charging points and can carry 2 1-liter bottles of water, although the passenger footwell is noticeably tight on wiggle room. Jaguar claims the cargo area offers 20.4 cubic feet of space with a rear seats upright, which sounds bigger than the space looks, so we'd advise bringing along your pushchair or golf clubs to your test drive, just to check your life fits. The E-Pace is based on the same platform as the Land Rover Range Rover Evoque, but it features substantial revisions that help give it a stronger road bias, plus further updates that will be filtered into the second generation Evoque. Jaguar hasn't been afraid to inject a bit of playfulness into its baby SUV, either. Not only can you specify an optional wristband called the Activity Key to open your car, visible in the lower windscreen and illuminated in the puddle lights is a scene that could have been grafted straight from the Jungle Book, a Jaguar in stealth mode, being followed by its younger cub. Jaguar bosses say a steel structure has helped improve interior packaging while making the E-Pace almost as stiff as the F-Type sports car. While that may be true, it also makes this baby SUV weigh nearly 2 tons. That's heavier than its bigger sibling, the F-Pace. Fluid in the corners the E-Pace may try to be, but you cannot disguise that weight under braking, acceleration, the braille ride quality, or in the suicidal fuel gauge. Cutting costs may be another reason for the choice of material change, but then this E-Pace doesn't seem to offer good value, either. Sure, pricing starts at £28,500 for the entry-level diesel, manual that nobody will buy. In the States, it's $38,600 for the base 2.0-liter gas engine with all-wheel drive. But even the 238-horsepower 2.0-liter petrol E-Pace, the cheapest gas engine, currently, which may well be the sweet spot in the range, is £40,000 if you want leather and those smart LED running lights, that'll get you the equally precise feeling Audi Q5 2.0 TFSI or the swanky and desirable Volvo XC60 T5R design, both of which are from the class above and therefore much bigger, more practical cars. You'll need to part with £50,000 for a version that resembles the E-Pace P300R design in these pictures. The loaded first edition model in the US, which doesn't get the 296 horsepower engine, starts at a lofty $53,550. Add items such as the panoramic roof, the adaptive dampers, even that wristband that thinks it's a key, and you could easily see your E-Pace priced nearer £60,000. Sorry, Jaguar, but even the bigger, faster, and dynamically more competent Porsche Macan S can limbo under the £50,000 barrier. For all its presence, prettiness, and on paper potential, the Jaguar E-Pace pushes style over substance, squeezing affordability, practicality, and mechanical refinement into the corner more than it should for this class of vehicle. While it may be a cool-looking, left-field choice, there are rivals that offer more space, performance, and better infotainment for similar money. Making a baby Jaguar SUV is a no-brainer. Making a Porsche Macan beater is clearly a lot tougher.